Welcome dear listeners, today we are going to discuss surface free energy. It is a phenomena related with the surface tension. Now surface free energy the molecule near the surface of the liquid have a more potential energy as compared to the molecules in the bulk of this liquid, means that the surface of liquid increases the more molecules have this excessive potential energy, and this energy is proportional to the size of free surface is called or surface free energy. For example, a liquid droplet assume a spherical shape because a sphere has a smallest surface area as compared to the other shapes. Then a surface of liquid work must be done against the surface tension. When you are pulling these molecules, then you are working against the surface tension. Suppose this A, B, C and D is a three-sided filled with movable bar, that is CD, means all these three sides A, B, B, C and AD are fixed, but this CD is a movable bar of length L, and a soap film is formed over this area A, B, C, D. Meaning during this area ABCD, soap film is formed. Then applying the force F to the movable bar, the film stretches to downwards. Okay, when we try to move this movable bar from this CD position to the C dash and D dash position, what happens? It try to stretch that soap film. So to break the film, some force is required. Okay, the film is formed in between this rectangle, that is ABCD, and when we are changing the position of this CD from C dash to D dash position, we are applying the force. First of all, what happens? This film stretches, and when you apply more force than that, it breaks. So is the applied force is less than what is required to break the film, retract due to this surface tension. Means the force required for breaking of soap film is equal to, or it is related with the surface tension of your liquid. Now, if force F is applied to this movable bar by a distance from D, okay, we are moving this bar at a distance D at position C dash and D dash. So work done is expressed is equal to F into D, that is force into the distance. So while stretching the film, force acts against the surface tension of the liquid and it tries to contract the liquid. The soap film has a liquid gas interface. The total length of contact film is equal to double of the length of bar because film has two surfaces. So therefore, the force acting on surface is expressed as mathematically F is equal to surface tension into 2L, Okay, initially we have calculated that work done is equal to force into distance traveled by your movable bar. And in second approach, this force is nothing but surface tension into length of that film, length of the surface. But this surface is available from both sides, upside of this rectangular film and from the back side of this rectangular film. It has a two surfaces. This is your upward surface. So we have kept here two. Then we'll discuss next part, that is combination of this equation 1 and 2 by substituting values of downward force in equation 1. Now our equation 1 is W is equal to F into D, and our equation 2 is F is equal to surface tension into 2L. Okay, when we put this value of F, that is gamma 2L, into this equation 1, we'll get equation 3, that is W is equal to gamma into 2 into L into D. Now the quantity of 2L into D is equal to increased surface area. Okay, D is this distance traveled by your movable bar, which is responsible to increase the surface area, and 2L is nothing but length of your film from both sides. So totally we can say that it is increased surface area produced by the extending film. So instead of 2LD, we can put the delta A, that is increased surface area. So your equation will become W is equal to surface tension into increased area, that is delta A, where W is work done, is increased surface energy expressed into the ergs. Now unit for the surface free energy is joule per meter square. This is all about surface free energy. Thank you.